Jerry Bakker, thanks for tuning in. We're talking about fruit, eating too much fruit. Some patients I see eat way too much fruit. We're talking like 10 pieces of fruit per day. I think that's far too much. I think eating anything in excess is not really good for the body. I've always maintained that fruit consumption is fine, like vegetable consumption, like meat consumption, but it should be in balance with other kinds of foods. Now, I'm not here to argue the different merits of diets, you know, whether you are a vegan or whether you are a paleo person. But what we're going to talk about is eating lots and lots of fruit all the time is not that flash, not that great. You're going to get too much fructose in your body. And studies certainly show that fructose, when taken in abundance, can in fact upset the intestinal permeability and even push a person into bad bacterial growth in the gut. So some mice and rat studies conducted has also shown that when fructose is in excess, it can also even create liver damage, you know, when you've got way too much of it. So it is a sugar, and it's not meant to be piled by large amounts into the small intestine, because the intestinal permeability studies have certainly shown to, you know, to be true. Also, people who tend to eat way too much fruit tend to have lower bacteroides levels, and the proteobacteria tend to go up. So they're going to get a uniquely shaped microbiome just around the type of foods that they eat. Say, pre-vitella bacteria, for example, really thrive in a gut where a person eats lots of fiber, particularly vegetable fiber. The bacteroides bacteria prefer a mixed kind of a diet, especially if there's a bit of meat in the diet. So a healthy person will have a balance of different classes of bacteria. But when you start really going crazy with the diet and eating way too much of one particular type of food, you're going to push up certain types of bacteria, you know, at the expense of others, and that can create a problem. So everything in moderation, nothing in excess. Now, we're not talking, of course, about high fructose corn syrup, which was developed in the 60s, which is just junk, and you find it in everything now, you know. You find it in chewing gum, you find it in soft drinks, you find it in so many foods now. Up to 60% of foods now in US supermarkets, for example, contain high fructose corn syrup. Now, that is not really good stuff at all to eat. So you want to try and avoid that as much as you can. So I am in favor of fruit, but I'm not in favor of, you know, 10 pieces of fruit a day. Definitely not. Thanks for tuning in.